We have a special guest with us to enlighten us with a different aspect, talking about the color therapy. And you'll be surprised, what is this color therapy? So today, she's here to answer all your questions. Our special guest is Nandini Murthy Madam. She's here. And on behalf of University of Mysore, Department of Studies in Zoology, and Department of Studies in Genetics and Genomics, a warm welcome you, Madam, for this session. And it's a pleasure indeed for me to introduce Madam to all of you. Nandini Murthy, she's Secretary, University of Mysore Alumni Association, and she is former Vice President of Indian Dietetic Association. She's a recipient of National Award in Holistic Health, and she's a nutritionist and wellness consultant. She's a motivational speaker. She used to give motivational speeches in many corporate companies. And she's a former center head at VLCC Mysore. She has written a book, The Health Mantras of Diabetics. And she did her diploma course in yoga and nature cure. And she's a recipient of Yoga Bhushana Award as well as Yashodamma Dasappa Award. She is recognized by Jilla Kannada Sahitya Parishad, and moreover, she is certified in acupressure, color therapy, magnetic therapy, auricular therapy, mudras, and corporate wellness. And she will enrich all of us with her lot of information and positive thoughts and positive awareness. With this brief introduction, a warm welcome to you, Madam, once again, and over to you.
Namaste. First of all, I humbly seek blessings from my guru, Dr. Ajay Mishra, who taught me this color therapy, and also to my lovely parents. My sincere gratitude and respectful thanks to all my well-wishers, and my special thanks to Malini Madam. First of all, color therapy. This is very, very interesting ones. Almost a few years ago, I learned this technique. I felt somewhere we have to treat ourselves because body has the capacity to heal on its own. So when that kind of, the structured and well-established, God has given such a beautiful creation, I don't think why we have to pop up pills. Simple. For simple headache, people try to pop up pills. So my mantra is kill the ill without a pill or a bill. When we can treat ourselves, why to pop up pills? It is, they want that immediate relief. So they just go under the mercy of this medications. I would always say from medication to meditation or medication to meditation. The choice is yours. So here, you all know sun, moon, stars. You can see that in our cosmos. And sunlight. Such a powerful God. And every day we do sun salutation. So why do we do sun salutation? It is only to energize ourselves. Energy is neither created nor destroyed. So through sunlight, what we are going to do? What we are going to get it? You know how plants manufacture its food through photosynthesis through the help of green pigment called chlorophyll. It will manufacture food on its own with the help of sunlight. So why not for human beings? Definitely it has its own answer, but we need to have a lot of patience. Color therapy is originated not just now. It has been depicted and used widely during Atharvana Veda. During the Vedas time, There are a lot of scriptures which are available. It is also called chromotherapy. And sunlight carries energy, so which warms up the earth. And it is the driving force behind all weathers and climate. Sunlight is a basic need of life. And all living organisms need to survive. And this light can be broken down into colors. So which indicates that color is also a basic need for life. The use of color to promote healing and wellness is also called as chromotherapy, where researchers in study how light enters into the body. You all must have studied. So, yeah, whether through the eyes of the skin, eyes or the skin, it determines what effects it has on our brain and our body as a whole. Can we have a slide, please? First slide. So color actually can also enter the body through the skin. The energy from the color is transferred to the specific organs where the energy is needed. The Institute of Clinical and Experimental Medicine in Russia have proven that cells communicate with each other light known as photons and microwaves. It has been discovered that white light helps relieve seasonal affective disorder symptoms and other types of depression. Color principles are also being used to help architects and town builders, not just in the field of psychology and but also in the medicine. Now, if you observe Navagraha, color represents. Even the week wise, Sunday, there is some color to be worn. Monday, white. Tuesday, red. Wednesday, green. Thursday, yellow. So the color goes on. The color wheel goes on. It is only to activate chakras. The next slide, please. The color of light plays an important role, as I told you, during photosynthesis. The plants use only certain colors from light for the process of photosynthesis. The chlorophyll absorbs blue, red, violet light rays. Photosynthesis occurs more in blue and red light rays and less or not at all in green light rays. The light that is absorbed, the best is blue. So this shows the highest rate of photosynthesis, after which comes red light. Green light cannot be absorbed by the plant and thus cannot be used for photosynthesis. Chlorophyll looks green because it absorbs red and blue light, making these colors unavailable to be seen by our eyes. It is the green light which is not absorbed that finally reaches our eyes, making the chlorophyll appear green. So white light, if you see the look at the prism, the glass prism, when you pass that light, white light is a combination of all rainbow colors. So we will use these colors and its associated energies to heal ailments of people, right? So during school days, we have done this experiment. You all know about it. Next slide, please. Now, these are the elements. We have physical elements, five physical elements and five metaphysical elements. The first element is Akash, the little finger on the right hand. Second one is Vayu, that is little finger of left hand. So you can see it's very simple technique. It starts from the smallest finger, right hand, then Akash, Vayu, number two, okay? So the colors, the numbers and the elements, you have to match it here. So it starts from Akash, Vayu. Next, number three is you go to the next height there only, the ring finger of the left hand, that is Agni. So the correspondent Agni is Jal. You can, you know, put off fire with the help of Jal, right? So the fourth ring finger right hand is your Jal. Again, go to the next finger, the other finger, that is a ring finger, is your Prithvi, right hand. So the correspondence right goes to the left hand, number six, Kal, that is time, that is a metaphysical element. So from six, you can jump into the tallest finger, Disha, right? So that is the seventh number. And the eighth number, the corresponding one is Man, that is our mind. And the last two elements, Tam and Atma. Atma represents number nine, and Tam represents zero. It says darkness, right? So let's look into the elements first. If you understand elements, you can easily learn color therapy. Next slide, please. So before we could learn about elements, sometimes many of us wake up in the middle of the night. So we have circadian clock in our body. What is the circadian clock? We have to do our things at the right time, at certain time. So you have to eat food at the right time. You have to have your exercise at the proper time. Let us look into that. 11 o'clock to 1 o'clock, 11 a.m. 9 a.m. to 11 is going to be your spleen. What it does? You have to be working and you have to be active. That is between 9 to 11 o'clock. You must have seen some people lying down even at 9 o'clock also. Now imagine what happens to our body. You have seen people working in IT sectors. They do night shift, and you can imagine what is going to be the effect on our body. So they don't see neither the sunrise nor the sunset, right? So it will disturb our biological clock. So there are 12 meridians in our body. What are those 12 meridians? That is heart, small intestine, bladder, kidneys, pericardium, triple warmer, gallbladder, liver, lungs, large intestine, stomach, and spleen. See, these are all 12 meridians wherein the heart pumps up the blood and focuses for every 2 hours to these particular meridians. For example, nighttime, let us imagine between 11 to 1 o'clock, gallbladder meridian will be working. So what you are supposed to do? Sleep, right? While you sleep, the body's cell starts regenerating, right? It is not degenerated, regenerated. If you don't sleep, yes, you are going to be the victim of degenerative diseases for sure. Again, from 1 to 3, it is your liver, the liver which keeps detoxifying, right? It is a deep sleep what you're going to do. And if you wake up between this time, there is something wrong. Maybe alcoholics, you know, the chemicals, drugs, all that, it may be poor diet, they're all definitely going to be detoxed by this liver. Such a beautiful mechanism, right? Between 3 to 5, you have to, you know, see the lungs. You are going to sleep soundly. 5 to 7, you have to do your exercise. So this is called circadian clock. So this is where our physical elements and metaphysical elements are going to work throughout 24 hours. We have to segregate, 8 hours sleep, 8 hours activity, 8 hours non-activity. You cannot stretch more. We have to have a proper sleep. We have to have our proper activity levels. You have to distribute and analyze yourself. Next slide, please. See, this is how the midday and midnight, like how it has been divided once again. How the elements are distributed. Suppose if you take between the timing, that is 5 to 7 p.m., the kidney will be working. So water, bladder, once again, 3 p.m. to 5 p.m., right? So that is where the bladder will be working. So water is the element there. So pericardium and triple warmer, two meridians in charge of what? Fire. Once again, wood, metal, earth, fire. All these are different elements which are residing in our body, and we need to have this in a proper proportion, and that's how our behavioral changes also takes place. Next slide, please. The first element is zero, tam, that is a darkness. So darkness is something represents black color. So what are the core attributes? See, absence of everything is zero. It indicates darkness. So for any creation to happen, nothingness is required. Like the proverb, necessity is the mother of invention. Therefore, wherever there is zero, there is time and opportunity for new creation. So the system of zero is everywhere in our body, mainly in the reproductive system to reproduce your like ones. It's also in every cell, blood, plasma, all tissues, in everything. So every time there is a creation of new cell or a tissue, and this is the power of tam, that is the darkness. So with the help of zero, we can create any tissue in the body, or a body can reproduce its like ones. Next slide, please. Number two is Akash. Akash represents the violet color. So if you see the rainbow, the first color is violet color. So the Akash, which I showed you, the little finger on the right side is going to be the Akash element. So what are the core attributes? That is, it represents softness, light, subtle, smooth, porosity, non-resistance, permeability, and sound. So you can observe these elements in an individual. Some people will be very, very soft and smooth. They are very calm. So that represents the, you know, Akash element. So the color violet gives flexibility to the body. It provides softness, the permeability, and it makes you lighter. The most scattered element is Akash. So flexibility means a flexibility of your muscles, your skin, spine, joints, and flexibility of your nature. Now you can imagine how yoga, whoever does yoga, Akash element will be on the higher side. It makes your skin soft. It maintains softness of each and every organ. So there is no rigidity as it is. So it, for example, it makes you a very soft spoken person. Permeability. What is permeability? It means the skin permits the air to come in, and it permits waste fluid to go out of your body. You permit anything to enter your body and to excrete and leave your body. So whether you permit any new idea or not, this is the permeability of your mind. Whether you permit any new, in other words, this is called acceptance or absorption, right? So Akash person can adjust himself anywhere, in any condition or situation, and they are open to any new ideas and thoughts. They will not resist. They will accept. That is the acceptance. You can observe such people. So less of Akash means it's rigidity, rigidness, stubbornness. They are not ready to accept. So we can treat the person's nature, body's rigidity, or a flexibility. If Akash is excessive, it will create flabbiness, loose muscles. So it tranquilizes, and tranquilizing actually helps here. Okay. So a paralytic patient may not be able to lift the arm, and tranquilizing Akash can induce the appropriate strength to lift the hand. I hope you can understand. A very high blood pressure person having a paralysis, we can treat Akash element. Tranquilizing means you are going to reduce the energy levels of this. See, as I told you, energy can be neither created nor destroyed. So when there is any blockages, we can either increase the energy or reduce the energy. So in case of paralytic patient, we can reduce that energy. That means it is too much of Akash, right? That's how it has been treated. Next slide, please. Vayu, that is air. You can see light, cold, it is dry, rough, transparent, subtle, micro, and touch. You can feel it and the movement. All these are the core attributes of Vayu. And the color represents is dark blue. It's a common blue as it is, like a Prussian blue. The dark blue has a drying effect and makes things rough, transparent once again, subtle, fine, and fatigued. It gives that cooling effect to inflammation. It cools burning sensation and dries up wound, right? If your wound is getting dried, it is only because of the Vayu element. Vayu means it makes things lighter. So however it is unstable, fickle, and it changes every moment. You cannot see air in the same place, right? It keeps moving. So a Vayu person you can easily make out. Is best suited to give a start to, he will not sit in one place. He keeps moving, right? You give a start to anything to Vayu person, he will complete any new projects. However, they cannot bring continuity or stability. They can be bored easily and are easy to win. They are people who shift from one activity to other at the same time. They could also be workaholics and very active. They are very good initiators. There is a lot of clarity and transparency, means whatever is inside is also on the outside. So Vayu people are like childlike. They are very innocent. They cannot keep anything bottled up. So the dark blue in excess makes you more active. However, it will lead to fatigue. Everything has fatigue, like physiological fatigue or a psychological fatigue. You would feel like a deflated balloon after being overly inflated, right? That is limp and lifeless. On the other hand, dark blue allows your brain to understand subtler concepts and meanings behind things. Deficiency can lead to low activity, insufficient muscular movements, and depression. So what happens if the Vayu is increased in our body? It can create high blood pressure, anxiety, frequent urination, diarrhea, trembling, palpitation, that is rapid heartbeat, increased pain. It can cause hemorrhages. So the above can be treated once again by reducing this energy, right? So Vayu is dark blue, and the next element we go with the Agni, that is fire element. So to energize, to reduce that Vayu, we apply this color. We tranquilize by the next color. If we want to increase the color, we apply that particular color. Hope you are following this. Now the fire, that is sky blue color. See, Vayu is dark blue. The fire represents light blue, that is sky blue. So the sky blue color has heating effect. You all know it melts, it burns. We can cook. You can see that, and it also digests the fire element. You can see a person standing right from feet to knee. It is earth element. From knee to, you know, till the reproductive organs, it is kidneys once again. That is water element. Again, from there, the intestine, stomach, it is fire, fire element. Again, near the lungs, it is air element. And at the top is Akash. See, the human body is divided into five physical elements. So it can change shapes and colors also. It melts blockages anywhere in the body and also burns the toxins. So if we have any toxins, we have to increase fire element. So whatever we eat is cooked at different levels by fire to make it. The extent of fire in our body determines the extent of digestion and assimilation of the various components in our food. As in the food, it is with the mental fire, that is our brain, it is our mental fire is sufficient or not. That is the indicative of our wisdom or mental maturity. Wisdom and discrimination, what we say in Kannada, like Viveka. That is that discrimination is an attribute which is due to this fire. Fire is life. There should be fire in your speech. your eyes, your touch, and your words. There, if there is a fire in a speaker, healers, teachers' words, it will enter our brain and melt any blockages. So how much of fire do we hold in our gaze when we look at something? What do we see, comprehend, or understand? The extent of fire element within us determines this. So ears likewise reflects our fire. Everybody listens differently. This means that we understand at different levels at different times. So change of color anywhere in your body tells about different levels of fire deficiency or excess. So for example, dark circles, right? Or leucoderma, tanning is all instances of different levels of fire. Sudden change in the shape of the body or joints or enlargement of internal organs, fibroids, cyst, fatty nodes are all due to the lack of excess of fire or heat in the body. So enhancing the fire in the brain semblance of a slow learner will help the person improve in his her or learning skills, right? So we can improvise this fire element for a slow learning child. Next comes the Jal. Jal represents green in color. As you all know, water. So water, what are the core attributes? Every fluid of our body is essentially water. You know, 70% to 75% of the body represents water than any other muscles, blood, or whatever is there. Water is dominating, right? So color, green gives lubrication, liquidity, and has a cooling down and a slowing down effect, makes things dull. Hence, it attributes moist, softness, stickiness, and cohesiveness, flowy, and it is detoxifying and pleasantness. So if we want to detox, we drink a lot of water, if you all know. So what is cohesion? Without water or a liquid, you cannot join anything. If anything breaks, you need liquid stickiness to join them. This combines larger life concepts of separation and union. It is said that love can join and mend anything. So the color of the green is, you know, associated with love. That is Anahata Chakra. So the Sahasra Chakra is violet. As I told you, it's Akash. Then comes the Bro Chakra, that is dark blue, right? Then comes the light blue, that is thyroid. People suffer from thyroid. That is, once again, Vishuddhi Chakra. So Sahasrara Chakra, Agna Chakra, Vishuddhi Chakra. Then comes the Anahata Chakra. It represents green color. So that is why it is associated with love, right? So the essential qualities of water is coolness and calmness. People who, become very calm and cool, they have, and who maintain good relationship. So relationship is also associated like flow of like a liquid, because if it stops flowing, it stagnates. It starts decaying. If you see water in that same place, it starts decaying. So the pleasantness means feeling you get living near the water. Sometimes I feel like going near the beach where there is too much of water. So even looking at water makes you feel very pleasant and calm, right? Less of Jal could mean no rhythm, improper blood circulation. In every joint of the body, there is a synovial fluid, which is Jal, that helps the joint for smooth movement, right? That means it helps, it acts like a lubricant, right? Similarly, if we take this concept into a struggled relationship, which means there is no flow of affection between the individuals involved in the relationship, and enhancing Jal can help build the relationship. The relationship will begin to connect again. So we can increase the green color. See the beauty of these elements. See the beauty. So dryness of the skin, throat, dry stool, etc. can be treated with Jal, that is water. And excess of water also can lead to edema. So tranquilizing the gel will help remove edema. So we can de-energize the element. Next comes the Prithvi. That is represents number 5. Can you change the slide, please? So what are the core attributes? Earth is heavy, hard, and very tough and rough also. So associated attributes are, it's very slow, solid, stable, dense, and gross. So Mother Earth, what is the character, the trait of Mother Earth? Cares. So that caring. So the element indicates care for everything. So stability is the essence. Solidity is like, is solidity in your body. If something becomes solid in your body, there can be a fibroid or a stone. Now you know how kidney stones are formed. Stability indicates support or support system in the body. Just imagine a person is having a more earth element. So that is the person who is going to experience constipation. So person who is having, who is constipated, even the thought process also is constipated. They always go back. They always think about, you know, almost a year's back story, and they repeat again. Even if you pull them down to come back to current situation, no, they will go back. So even their mind thought process is also constipated. So it is our body weight, but it can also be a weight in our sentences also. Its quality is slow. Earth element is very slow in its character. So a Prithvi element person will ask all possible questions and follow instructions. They follow a process and bring stability and continuity to any project. So they are nurturing and supportive, loyal and dependable. See the traits, how we can actually make use of such people who are having a particular element when they have more. So less Prithvi element could lead to all this diarrhea, loose motions, prolapse, irregular periods, etc. So people, many females, you know, adolescent group, they are suffering from PCOD. So we can actually treat this particular Prithvi element by, you know, we can increase Prithvi element. Less Prithvi can lead to irregular periods. So when we improvise this particular element, it will be treated. Next comes Kal, number 6. Next slide, please. Kal represents orange color, time and timing, sensitivity, meals. I am hungry now means you have to take meals. The time will tell you, it's a metaphysical element. We cannot see. At least you can see fire. You can see those are all visible, but these are invisible. Bowel movements, early morning. Yeah. You know, we need to have a proper bowel movements. Then menstrual cycles, maturity, puberty. At the time of birth, now people decide the time of the birth. They want that particular time for the birth. It is not natural. And conception, all these are the attributes, the core attributes of Kal. Our feelings are attached to our various sense organs, to see, to taste, to hear, or to touch, and whatever we perceive is due to the nervous system of our body. So it is termed as Kal, as it regulates the timing in our body or the organ clock. Organ clock means, I think I described earlier in my slide about circadian clock. Okay, so at what time do we sleep and for how long, the timing of meals or the bowel movements, anything, all these, thus it has its own significant part of our lives, and that is defined by time. So what is the sensitivity? The orange color can improve our sensitivity and our sense organs. So physical senses of sight, hearing, touch, smells, taste, and all other non-physical senses are affected by it. However, if this sensitivity is too high, it gives us allergies. So hypersensitivity, dust allergy, etc. are all excess of Kal. Kal means time. So deficiency of Kal is low sense of hearing or nose, that is they can't smell it. And even the sight also is not, they don't have a good proper sight. Next slide, please. 7, Disha. Is represents red color. It is a metaphysical element. Represent, it is called direction. So this is the force or a direction, the sense of direction in us. So this force is inside every organ, blood vessel, everywhere. So everything has a direction. Even when we look for information, we search outwards. And when we receive answers, they are directed inwards. So actually, if this direction reverses, if this direction stops, if the pace of the direction accelerates, so there are different way of direction. So to illustrate this, to consider what happens when a breakfast which is meant to travel downwards comes up. Diarrhea, vomiting are instances of reversal of direction. Disha means direction, impacts perception and our understanding of one another. Communication is a two-way process that requires both parties to follow the same direction. What happens when our direction clash? We have different points of views and biases. So communication becomes very difficult. So some of the examples of shifting of disha, direction, includes addiction, that is chewing tobacco, addiction of stomach, alcoholism, then navel dislocation, that is lack of balance, slip disc, then space between the joints, that is especially knees, that is dislocated joints. All these are the examples of direction, disha. So the sense of direction makes Ram or Ravan, like Osama or Obama, like that. The eighth one element, next, Man. Man represents pink in, it's pink in color. It's a metaphysical element. So what are the core attributes? Subtle metaphysical power of the mind, possibly the strongest force in nature. Man, the mind, this is the factor that ensures success in any kind of work, whether it is physical, metaphysical, or emotional. The real satisfaction of any deed being done in the man and nowhere else, neither in the body nor in the physical or metaphysical world. Once our mind is attracted to something, whether it is a person or a place or thing, it will seek and find satisfaction only in that thing. If we get up what our man, that is mind, desires, we feel like a winner, satisfied and happy and full of energy. On the contrary, if we fail to acquire what we desire, the illness starts to grip our minds and finally ends with the physical manifestation. So man is the connection of our body with the external world. Our mind has a certain subtle power. It establishes a connection with whatever it seeks, and unless the mind is distracted, it achieves it. So just as the mind has power to change the outer world, it can also alter our inner world, that is our inner internal organs. If we start exploring our body with our mind, we find an increase in activity in the parts that we concentrate upon. It increases the energy of that area. Conversely, it is a good to remove our man, that is our mind, from the places that pain or diseased, right? Wherever there is a pain, more you focus, the pain increases. So concentrating our mind on the areas of pain will only serve to increase the affliction. Interestingly, if we remove our mind from there by hypnosis, we feel no pain. Most of the diseases are of the mind. That is mind over matter. That is nothing but today, many people are suffering from so many ailments. I can say 70 to 80% are all psychosomatic disorders. So the power of mind is affected by the color of pink. So all types of mental illness can be cured by using this pink color. It's a pink color, right? The power of mind is just pink color. So to improve your concentration, to improve your memory power, we use this pink color. So hyperactive children can be calmed down by working on the mind. So this is, that completes man element. And next comes the Atma. Atma is Shri. Shri, we say Shri, right? The black is called Shrijit. So Shri, Sri Chakra, people wear Sri Chakra. It provides energy, prana, right? That is called bioenergy. So what are the core attributes? Atma performs no action. However, the presence of Atma is imperative for everything to function. The difference between a living body and a dead body is because of this bioenergy, prana, Atma. The separation of the bioenergy from the physical body is death. So the basis of any metaphysical treatment is Atma. It provides the energy through man or mind, and mind takes energy from Atma to each and every energy part of the body as required. So this is the Atma, which indicates new creation. Next slide, please. Now, friends, you can observe Su Jok means, you know, we treat so many things in our, on a hand, palm. These acts like a remote button. Now you can see whatever I told you, all the chakras are aligned. It starts from Sahasrara chakra, that is the thumb, which represents your face, the lungs, you know, you can see there the Sahasrara chakra, then comes the Vishuddhi chakra and Anahata chakra. Till that, you can see almost all the chakras there. Once again, these are all mind chakras. Anahata chakra is in the middle, and then comes all three bottom chakras, that is Manipura, Swadhisthana, and Muladhara chakra. So all three body chakras related to body, and three are related to mind. And in between, Anahata chakra represents green in color. And I have colored accordingly as per that. And you can see this is how we treat the two middle fingers, that is the tall finger and the ring finger represents the feet, right? The lower limbs, and the upper limbs are right, that is a forefinger, and the last finger represents the hands, upper limbs. And in between the palm, it represents your stomach, intestine, lungs, liver, heart, everything there. So this is how we put the colors on the respective areas, right? And with the help of elements. Next slide, please. So this is a beautiful chart. Once again, it's a color chart. So this is how we treat based on their problem. A person comes with any problem, we try to treat. So the, as I told you, the little finger from Akash, Vibgayar, color, violet, indigo, blue. That is 1, 2, 3. You remember like this. Akash, Vayu, Agni is 1, 2, 3. Next comes 4, Anahata chakra, Jal element, 4. Then the rest of 5, 6, 7, the rest is yellow, orange, and red. And then comes the pink color. So all and Atma Pan, Shri Jan, all these are right and left palm we treat. So to increase the color, we put the respective colors. To decrease the color, we go to the next color. Suppose if I have to increase, Vayu, which color I have to put? Sky blue or dark blue? Dark blue, right? Dark blue represents sky, Vayu. Suppose I have to reduce Vayu, then I have to put Agni, the light blue color. So I have to tranquilize or enhance. Only two combinations can happen. And this is how we try to play with colors to heal a person, right? Hope you all could understand with this simple chart what has been represented here. Don't you think it's such a beautiful thing? Without taking any medications, we can treat ourselves. Yes, next slide, please. See, this is once again a beautiful chart where invisible and how it is synthesis can happen with the help of chakras, the colors, and like one side it's physical and psychological, the chakras, how it has been depicted, and how our system. Now everybody wants immunity. Where is that immunity stands there? Akash. So your Akash element should be on the higher side to improvise your immunity under this COVID situation. Then comes our endocrine glands. So it's a master gland, the pituitary gland, which is located below, you know, here near the hypothalamus. And then comes C, there is a bilawd, is endocrine gland. Nervous system is a teacher. Respiratory system is child. Blood vascular system is mother. Love, it represents love. Digestive system is a friend, happiness. Reproductive system is Sadguru, purity. Skeletal and muscular system is father. See how they are beautifully they have represented. And excretory system. So this is how we can actually maintain our health so well. You know, we can maintain prudent health by following proper, you know, rituals. Next slide, please. So what I was trying to explain, to increase the Akash element, we put violet color. If we have to reduce the Akash element, I have to go to the next color, that is indigo, that is Vayu's color. Like this, it goes on. Any doubts, you can call me later. Next slide, please. See, this is the body semblance on our hands. So whatever is the whatever is facing this is in, Y-I-N, inside. That's a female. And whatever represents outer side represents yang side, right? So in and yang. So see the structure, how it has been depicted on the hand. And similarly, based on the elements, we try to balance this. If we have a backbone, I mean backache, we try to treat on the yang side. If we have some, you know, headache or whatever, we try to treat here on the inside. Y-I-N, in, and yang is male. Yin is female. Next slide, please. See, we have phalanges, like, you know, finger is divided on the top, middle, and the bottom, right? So the top is nothing but your head and neck, the distal, the first phalanx. So if you come to the middle, middle means middle and the second phalanx, lungs and heart, that is the middle one, middle, right? The relevant area of a spinal cord on back and right, left arms on either side. So middle. And the bottom is nothing but your liver, spleen, stomach, pancreas, all that. It's so beautifully it is represented in this illustration. So both front and back, and also towards side also it has been given. If any joint problem, we can treat on the edge of the finger, towards the edge of the finger. We try to put colors there and we try to treat on the edge. So I don't know how much it is visible, but in and inner side and yang is outer side. This is how we put the colors here, right? Yes. Next slide. These are different protocols, probably. If you want to increase your memory power, I think most of the students who are watching here, they can put that purple color on the thumb, on the top of the thumb. You know, here the brain, it's a brain correspondence. So kindly put purple or a violet color. This is the color represents memory power. So that you can write just like this.
How long it has to
be? Yes. After application of this, probably about 15 to 20 minutes, you can show it to sunlight. So the sunlight penetrates and it will work on your organs. It is such a simple therapy, right? Next slide. Many people are suffering from thyroid. So just now I showed you in that figure, the near the throat, that is the green color, which you have to apply. So which is that green color? Green color represents jal, right? So that green color has to be applied there. Next, this is for hypothyroid. See, hyperthyroid, once again, the color changes. It's yellow color. So there's difference between hyper and hypothyroid. Next slide. Okay, if there is any asthma problem, breathlessness, the red color has been applied there. The application is applied exactly on the lung part. So this part is lungs, right? Next slide. If you want to be happy always, apply that pink color, mind, exactly here, right? Whatever is representing there, you can apply, take a pink color and start applying here. Pink color, sorry. It's the pink color which you can apply here to feel happy always. So every who doesn't want to be happy? I don't think anybody can say no. Everybody wants to be happy, right? So you can apply pink color. Yes, next.
How many times do they have to apply?
They will ask questions for sure. Okay. Yes, any color can be applied anywhere between 15 to 30 minutes and it has to be shown to sunlight. And even at night also you can apply in the sleep, it keeps working, but when you expose towards the sunlight, it will work more. For any kidney problem, this is the point, kidney point, we apply. Next slide. These are protocols what we treat for our patients. If they have, see, I told you these two are legs and these two are hands. So for leg problem, we apply that red color on the young side. It's not in young, right, left. Next slide. For high BP, blood pressure, so near the heart, we put this blue color. Next slide. For eyesight, you all are watching after lockdown, you all have to attend, Zoom classes, right? So please apply this green color here, wherever you can write down eyes, there a green color, it will soothen. It will calm so that you will not have any eyesight problem, which is very, very important. Please note down. Next slide. For people who have acidity, so gastritis and all, they can apply this green color and while sleeping also they can apply. And even they can do daytime also they can apply and expose to sunlight. Tooth problem. So see near behind young side, just you have to write the borderline in green color. So that is once again green or even black also you can apply. So that's for the tooth problem. During lockdown, where can you go? If you know all these simple techniques, you can heal yourself. I want every person to become doctor for themselves. So let me end this. Doing your best at this moment puts you in the best place for the next moment. So this color therapy must have helped you even within the short time. I have tried to cover all the elements. I made you to understand because this is not something new. Once again, I'm trying to tell you. Of course, in Mysore, I want many people to learn this course. And anybody wants to learn course, you are always welcome. I've already started in batches. So this is all about color therapy. I'm open for questions.
Yeah, madam, it's a wonderful session. But some of the things about the metaphysical element, when you explain, maybe probably above the head, because students still, they are not that mature to understand the metaphysical element. Physical element, everyone can accept. Metaphysical means some maturity has to be there. Okay. Yes. As ages, if they are more well-versed with the spiritual things, so then they can understand some of these things. Other than that, they can have...
Metaphysical elements are totally insidious, hidden.
Yeah, they don't know much. Yeah, exactly.
It is like when you switch on the light, the light comes there,
yes,
or the fan goes.
Yes.
So did you know, understand how it came?
Yeah.
You cannot see that, yes, right? Similarly, yeah, inside our internal organs, yes, also, it has its own, with all that stimulus, nervous system, with the help of, mind works,
yes,
pushes that energy to the nervous system, and then only it can help. It has its own stimuli and gives that signal, and then only it will.
Yeah.
All these are metaphysical elements connected to mind.
Yes.
Brain. Cannot, mind means it is not here.
Entire body. Entire body,
body is
considered, yes, as a mind. So they'll be having a lot of questions, doubts, I hope. You can interact, you can ask questions and clarify the things. even about the color therapy, simple things.
And if there is anything complicated things, they have to meet me.
Good evening, ma'am. I'm Dr. Chaitra from genetics department.
Yes,
ma'am, it was an excellent talk and a very refreshing talk, because always we'll be studying about the physiology, genetics and all. But this is completely different, very, very colorful talk. So, ma'am, while explaining, you were telling about the Vayu people and the gel person and all. So how will you determine, like, what person, which category does he belong? Like, if I come, so how will you decide that?
When I did my course, my teacher actually, he blessed me. Nandini, you are blessed with Jal and Disha. Jal means it's water. So he must have seen me. I don't sit in one place. I'm very aggressive person. I keep moving like water. Water doesn't stand in one place until unless if you keep it in a container, right? Otherwise, if you just see any river, stream, anywhere, water is not something, it is unstoppable. So that water is there in me. That is what he identified based on my behavior, based on my character, my traits. So based on my, you can make out a person is aggressive or a very assertive person. You can keep observing. Definitely you can make out. So he blessed me with Jal and Disha. Disha means he blessed me, give your nourishment with directions to all. So direction means I have to give, direction means I told you, when you eat food, it has to go down. It cannot come up. If it comes up, what happens? We start puking. We can start vomiting. So the direction has to go inside only. So this is not to be seen. This is, suppose if I'm driving my car, I'm supposed to come to Vigyan Bhavan. I have to come at that time, particular time, at right direction, right? If I'm lost, I might go to somewhere. I'm lost somewhere. That means internally, that metaphysical element direction is lost. A person who is not maintaining time, coming late to the class, his time is not proper inside the body. It is as simple as that. Correct?
Thank you.
If you make up your mind, once again, mind has to give all this. Mind controls all this, disha or time, whatever. Correct?
Yes.
So all this together comprises this Atma. That is the white light. You can see the aura of a person sometimes. Person who is very positive, you can see that aura in their face. A person who is very dull, haggard, lethargic, no energy, you can feel that by looking at that person only. You can make out, oh, person is lazy. A person talks negative. So you can classify things based on their elements.
That is the beauty of this. Thank you, ma'am, for your clarification.
You.
A question by Pujita MN. 4-year-old is unable to speak fluently. So what could be the solution, ma'am? He is a premature born at 32 weeks.
See, certain things are like, you know, inborn. So inborn, the inborn error of metabolism. There are so many things, you know. These, you know, with respect to the elements, whatever is there, I have a list of, ailments which I can show you now. Maybe whatever in my limits I can treat. But like speech and hearing, or those are the people who are right doctors to treat.
Other than that, this is a supportive one.
These are all alternative and supportive therapies. For any person, it can be a diabetic or hypertensive. This is going to be like a supplementary. Alternative therapy.
A question by Vijay Kumar. Madam, yeah. How many minutes we have to expose to sun after the application?
After the color application, minimum 20 to 30 minutes. Minimum. Okay. You have to apply and keep it like this and expose it. The sun has to penetrate deep into the epidermis level and it has to get connected to that particular organ. So minimum 20 to 30 minutes is permissible.
Madam, I have a question.
Yeah.
how this negative attitude of a person, for example, if students are lethargic and not very active. How to motivate them or how to bring them some kind of positive
negative? Is it through elements you want, or see, there are foods which are positive foods. Not only, I know, if you are asking for the student, it is basically what we eat we are and how we digest we are. If you have consumed tamasic food, you will become, it's a negative food once again. If you consume sattvic food, it's a positive food. So what we eat we are means everything is going to reflect on our body. Correct? Our thinking levels also will reflect on what we eat. So that is why sattvika, rajasika and tamasika, it has been classified into three categories. So try to eat food which are near to the God. They are all sattvic foods to improvise our positivity. Positive. That is acid and base, acid and alkaline. That is 1 to 7 is acidic and 7 to 14 is pH is alkaline. The more you eat all fruits, vegetables, all God-made foods are alkaline. Whatever man-made foods are acidic foods. Example, gobi manchuri, all deep fried foods, all the cooked ones, all comes under acidic region. So 7 is neutral, our saliva is neutral, 7.35 pH, and 7 and above is alkaline foods. See the beauty of it, like how God has prepared. Anything natural food is going to be alkaline.
Diet and lifestyle.
Everything, everything matters. As I told you, yoga, when you do yoga, your body flexibility and endurance and all that improvises. So what happens? Our Akash element will be increased. Yes. So we are going to energize our own elements inside.
Yes.
Why many people are still look young?
Yes.
Even though they are aged, but they still, their skin is very beautiful. It is reflecting from inside. It is not that what they wear it. It is from inside. They have to grow from inside. It is based on how they nurture themselves to improvise, to balance all these elements. Yes.
There is one question. Like if somebody has multiple problems, whether they can apply multiple colors.
Exactly. We can. We can do that. Okay. Very good question. Madam is asking if anybody is having multiple issues, we can treat multiple. Different colors also can be treated. Even I treat myself, whatever, when I am a human being, I might find I have little varicose veins. I treat myself. I don't pop up any pills. The other day, somebody was asking, why are you applying this color? I just took that green color, and these two are the lower limbs, and just I applied in the, like this, I applied. So this is for the varicose veins or the sciatica, whatever pain. I address myself. I treat myself. I don't want to pop up any pills or, you know, take up any medications. You know, on the long run, how it is going to affect our internal organs, right? So it has its own side effects. These colors are externally applied. It is not going inside your body as it is. And why not?
Madam,
to
how
go
long
with
you
this?
Have to apply? How long? Duration?
Duration
how
is...
How many days, for example?
Till it subsides. You will feel it. Now, when once it is stopped, I will stop it. I have to observe myself. Nobody can, you know, observe. You know, we have to do our own introspection. Until unless my pain subsides, I will not. I mean, I will continue to treat myself. When the pain is totally nullified, I'm going to stop it. Why should I apply again? It is as simple as that.
Madam, I have a doubt.
Yes.
Whether the color of dress, what we wear, whether it reflects our daily routine activity.
Yes, definitely. Very good question, actually.
Something like that.
Yes, yes, very much. See, Thursday, we are supposed to wear yellow or orange. You are wearing yellow and orange. Very good. And it is a vibrant color. As I told you, each element represents different color. So that particular energy will be synthesized in our body. Like madam is wearing red with yellow. It's like, it looks like kumkum and turmeric. So the red, why do we wear red bindi? Why not any other color? Some people wear black, which is not actually correct. But red color is always important here. It controls your mind. So that is why we have to wear red color. And we put turmeric also to the feet. Why do we put it? It is yellow in color. Not only it's yellow color, it is going to have its own, you know, pull up our immunity. Earlier, they used to put turmeric here on the face. Nowadays, nobody puts it. But why? Once again, to build up the immunity. So the color has its own impact on our body.
But there are a few questions, like somebody has asked that her child is hyperactive, whether that can be controlled by color therapy.
Definitely, definitely.
And how long they have to expose? If the multiple colors they are applying, then how long
they
are going to expose?
Same time. Whether you want to cook rice, a glass of it, or whether 10 glasses, timing, cooking time is the same. That is how it is.
And another question, should we use marker or natural paint?
Come again?
Should we use marker or the natural?
This is the pen which I use it. This is the pen, sketch pens I use it. It doesn't cost much actually. It comes in a bottle actually, all these sketch pens. So I use these sketch pens. Not marker pen. This is a lot.
Another one question is that, what time is ideal to expose the color? Like ideal time to expose those colors.
Early morning is better. Okay.
These are the few questions which they have asked.
Okay.
Hope they have brought.
Fine.
So if they can't do in the morning, whether they can apply and the sleep in the night.
Definitely. That it keeps working. Very, huh? See, when you have the sunlight, you use it.
Yes.
When you don't have sunlight, now it's monsoon.
Yeah.
But you can still apply.
Yes.
You it keeps healing. Mm-hmm. Definitely it is going to heal on its own. Yes. Any more questions?
So if you have any clarification or query, please interact with madam. Few more questions we can.
You can show some of the slides, which towards end I have put up some more slides about the protocols. Yes. From the beginning, from you can show. After this, yeah.
One.
From A. This is the first one?
Yes.
Yeah.
This one question.
Yeah.
4-year-old is unable to speak.
They asked already. I answered. See, some of the protocols like stomach, they have ulcer. So we treat, we tranquilize or energize. We put that number. That is the, what is that number represents? The element.
Mm.
Okay. So 2-3, that is our protocol. Either we enhance or we tranquilize, we reduce. Varicose vein is there anywhere in the body. So it is 3 and 7. What is 3 and 7? Immediately you have to remember number 3, that is Akash Vayu. Next comes your fire. So that is number 3. So you have to reduce that fire element or increase the element. That is what has been given there.
We have another one. For dark circle, which color to be used?
Heat is more, no? Fire is more. The fire element has to be reduced. I mentioned when I was discussing about the fire element. People who have excess heat in their body, they have this dark circles.
And you have given that table. There, yes. You have given how to tranquilize.
Tranquilize, yes.
Colors.
Even for cycles, if they have this, snoring habit, we can treat here. For any itching, skin problem, or if they have frozen shoulders, we can treat. And next slide, please.
Quite common in
especially with females. Students, yes.
Right. Uh-huh. So that will be.
See, PCOD. Once again, 3, 6, 8. 3 and 6 and 8. What are those elements which I taught you? Number 3 is fire. Correct. Number 6.
Fire.
Number 6. Once again is kal. That is time. And number 8 is man. So 3, 6, 8, that is Agni, Kal and Man. 3 things I have to increase in PCOD. And 4, 5, 7, I have to reduce. See, these are the meridians where it is responsible, liver and ovaries. For PCOD, liver and ovaries are responsible. So I have to reduce 4, 5, 7. What is 4, 5, 7? Jal, then Prithvi and Disha, direction. That is PCOD, madam, irregular cycles.
Is there any limitation of this therapy? Sometimes
see,
we have some limitations for some therapy, even whether
there is no side effects. One thing I can say, because it is not going inside your body, there is no side effect. Most economical method. I want the whole humanity wants to learn this. For example, immunity. Improve how to improve your immunity. You have to increase your 3 and 6. That is Agni and Kal. Kal means time, and you have to reduce. 4 and 5. Mainly kidney and liver are the meridians where, you know, every alternate days you have to apply this. 4 and 5 you have to reduce. 4 is Jal and 5 is Prithvi. You have to reduce that in terms of immunity like this. So I have, it's very easy for me. So this is the table which I follow for my patients, and I apply, because I meet a lot of patients like diabetes patients or hypertensive patients or PCOD patients, or for immunity problem, even for premature graying, gray hair, you can prevent. Many people apply color. So premature graying also is there, where fire element or 3 and 6 can be increased and 4 and 5 can be reduced like this. So if your kidney element is more in that region and energy is more, you have to reduce for premature graying. Kidney and stomach are the main thing. Mm-hmm. We say it's gut. Anything starts from gut feeling. Mm-hmm. So all the problems starts from here, gut.
Okay. So we don't have any queries or questions, clarifications from the participants. Now I request Dr.
Gray hair put in the, I didn't go with this.
Dr. Bidisha to do vote of thanks.
Thank you, ma'am. I would like this opportunity to propose a vote of thanks in this occasion. First of all, I would like to thank our guest, Nandini Murthy ma'am, for providing us such a beautiful information that how this proper color treatment, it is a non-invasive technique which is going to not give any kind of side effects. So I think this is one of the best things which you can apply in your day-to-day life to protect yourself from various types of disease in this pandemic situation. Many are getting divided. So I feel this information is going to help you in a very nice way. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this beautiful information.
Thank you.
And I also take this opportunity to thank our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor G. Hemant Kumar, for providing opportunity and facilities to organize program like this. And special thanks to our ma'am and the chairperson of DOSM Zoology and Genetics for organizing such a beautiful program, which is like this topics mainly is quite good for this time and age. And my deep sense of appreciation and thanks to all the participants, research scholars and MSc students who has chosen to be live with us in this today's session and make it more successful. Thank you all. And my deep sense of thanks to all the technical staff of IRE and IRE members, Mr. Miller and Mr. Devendra, for providing technical supports for making this webinar webcast in a proper form. And thank you all for joining us today. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you.